Hello and welcome to Tech. I am Mohammed Adnan and in this video we are going to discuss about how to create a Pareto chart, that is 80-20 rule chart in Power BI. It's a real world case and solution in Power BI, as this chart is not available by default, but we had to create a similar kind of with the existing options. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Now let's get started. Before we begin, let's understand the Pareto principle. The Pareto principle, also known as 80-20 rule, states that for many events, roughly 80% of the effect come from 20% of the causes. A Pareto chart is a type of chart that contains both bars and a line graph, where individual values are represented in descending order by bars and the cumulative total is represented by the line. So if you look at the image here, I mean the chart, totally we have the defects here, the value of defects, and we have sorted them on a descending order. The highest defects is on the left side and it goes on decreasing to the right side. And also we have one more line graph which says it starts from 100 and ends till the last. So the place where it meets to the 80%, here I have drawn a line, the blue line here, the 80%. The place where it intersects here, if you go down straight here, in that case, what will happen is the crack, the part missing, and then the shrinkage. These three defects is causing more value when compared to the others' defects. So this will be helpful for industry. So for example, this industry itself is an automobile manufacturing industry. So in that, the most defect when it comes from the manufacturing unit is based on the crack and part missing and then the shrinkage. So they have to focus on these areas in order to reduce that defect quantity. Now let's have a look at the table, how I have done that. So here is a list of defects and sorted by quantity, and I've given the rank column based on the descending order of the total number of quantity. After that, I have added one more column, which is the cumulative based on the descending order. So each and every defect is cumulative of these things. And also the final one is the total sum of defects and the percentage of it. By using these parameters, we can easily get this chart. Here, what are the fields I have taken here? One, on the x-axis I have taken the defect, the column series nothing, and on the column value I have taken the quantity, whereas in the line graph I have taken the 80 target is a target for 80%, and also the percentage column here. So percentage, quantity, and defect. If you go back here, percentage, quantity, and then the defect name. So additionally, to achieve the percentage, we need these three columns: rank, cumulative sum, and then the total sum. So let's have a look at the DAX functions, how I have written that. The first is, we'll take as the total sum, is just a sum. So this is a DAX function, total sum, sum x. I have taken all of the defects sum the table, comma the defect quantity. And then I have taken the rank function based on the quantity descending order. So let's have a look at the rank now. Here I have taken the rank x function, defect sum table name, and then the quantity. It's by default, it is a descending order, so it is taking in the descending order. I have made a video about the rank functions. If you haven't seen that, just click on the link given on top of your screen. Now coming back to this one, and then cumulative percentage. For this, first of all, I have taken the maximum rank, the maximum defect rank column. So it is, the rank is totally how many defects you have. In return, I'm using the calculate function. So calculate sum of defect quantity, comma defect sum rank. So rank column is less than or equal to the maximum rank. So for each and every rank, it will accumulate the values. To make a running total, cumulative total, we need at least some unique columns on that. So here I use this rank column as a unique feature. So this is from rank 1 to 8. It will add up values here one by one. So total sum we have seen now, and the last thing is the percentage. The percentage column I have taken here, divide cumulative total, this one divided total sum. So by dividing these two, we got this value here. So this 21,000 quantity and consists of 56% here, and this is comes of 72, because we are accumulating this value actually. This we are taking the percentage of cumulative sum, so it is 56, 72, 80. So these three defect itself covers the 80% of the total value of the defects. This is how you can able to create a Pareto chart with the existing chart available in Power BI. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it on the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.